Okay, let me just project this onto my main monitor so I can have a bigger screen to read off of. Okay, let's go continue. Good morning, Hermia. You just sleep well last night. Sorry, I just can't seem to put my heart into it. Hermia. Hermia. Something about that name just doesn't sound right. It's still a mess out here! What the hell are you doing? You're damn good for nothing! That came from the square. Shall we see what's going on, Hermia? You bet we shall. Fairy discrimination. This is awful! We can't possibly put on another feast tonight! Why didn't you do anything? You hate Hermia or something?
Not at all. It's just. I forgot what I was supposed to do. The next thing I knew, it was morning and you were all yelling at me.
Looks like it happened to her again, Doga. Guess we're SOL. Ugh, forget it. I should have known better than to ask you in the first place. Just go! Get lost and don't ever come back near the village. I don't want to see your stupid face again.
Really? Thank you so much for forgiving me. I hope you'll invite me to the next one too.
Fairy discrimination. Oh, hey, Hermia. Yesterday was sure was a hoot, huh? You had that fairy girl clean up everything by herself? Oh, that fairy girl. Hey, what was her name again? How should I know? Damn, what was it again? I think she told us when she first showed up. I'm pretty sure it was Ho or Fu or something stupid like that. Bro, what the fuck? Is that what it was? She had a name at first too. Oh well, once you start forgetting your own name even without the fog, you're done for. Don't bother about her, Hermia. You don't want to catch her nameless disease. Oh, so she doesn't have a name. Is that why you treat her like that? What do you mean? No fairy without a name's worth anything, right? It's not like anyone would miss something if they were gone. Yeah, she doesn't have a place here, and her tent's outside the village. Yep, our territory just doesn't have room to spare for her, but I will say I'm impressed she's still alive. Doesn't have room for her. Meanwhile, hey, three outsiders we found and dragged into the village. Hey, you get your own tent. There you go. What the fuck? Jesus Christ, dude. She might get more banged up every day, but she's still got her arms and legs. Who knows? Maybe she used to be some kind of big shot. Not that that's doing her much good now. Guess not even the beasts of the forest got any interest in nameless meat. Anyway, that's enough about her. Come on, Hermia. I told you we're going to play football at noon today, right? See you at the see you or see you at the see you at the athletic field. Can't read. What would you like to do now that they've left for the athletic field, Hermia? You know anything about nameless fairies, Mash? I do. As the name suggests, they're fairies who've lost their names. While we lost our memories in the nameless woods, sometimes fairies lose their names all on their own. In general, fairies don't age or die like humans or animals. But we are born with a purpose, something we can lose ourselves in. Fairies who lose that purpose lose their names, and then grow steadily weaker until they die. That's what happened to that girl. It must have been quite some time since she lost her name. So is it true that she really doesn't have a home here? I'm sure it is. Fairies tend to shun fairies who've lost their names. Honestly, the fact that she's even allowed inside this village speaks volumes about these fairies' generosity. I know what you're thinking, Hermia, but we can't. If we invite her to stay in our tent, it'll really upset the fairies in this village. The best we can do is visit her home and get rid of anything that might be dangerous. We may not be able to invite her into the village where it's safe, but I'd be happy to at least make her home just as safe as the village. I knew you'd come through, Mash.
Huh? Why are you holding my hand?
Whoa.
You're shaking my hand to express your gratitude and faith in me, huh? That's a new one on me. Well, there's something really nice about it. I think I like this custom too, Hermia.
Handshakes are a foreign concept, huh? She's already under attack! There, I've driven the beast back a bit and opened up some space for the girl. I swore my butcher bow that I won't let them take another step toward her. Thank you, Tristram. I'll take it from here. Hey, you leave her alone right now! Alright, we fighting. Oh yeah, wait, reset time, isn't it? Oh yeah, it's reset time. Come on. There we go. Okay. Now I gotta go through that cutscene again. And get back to where we're supposed to be. Oh wait, oh, I keep forgetting. I keep forgetting I could just turn on without buffing up like that.
おとなしくなさい。白兵戦行きます。戦う。はい。ここで真っ直ぐ切り刻む。
Cruel though it may be, I made sure to aim for spots that would be extra painful. Hold up. Hopefully this will teach the other beasts that this part of the forest is dangerous. I agree, that seems like the best way to go. At any rate, that was amazing shooting, Tristram. Are you sure you don't remember being a soldier, or maybe a hunter? Either way, the king you used to serve must have been proud to have you. Yes, well, I certainly hope so.
Oh, that's weird. I can't sense any magical energy when he plucks his harp. Does that mean he's from the Wind Clan? But then he doesn't seem to have enough magical energy for that.
Are you okay?
Huh? What's going on? Did you do that for me? Yes, we did. Hermia insisted on checking up on you. Are you alright? Did those beasts hurt you before we got here? Oh no, I'm fine. I'm used to this sort of thing.
Aww.
So, is there something more I can do for you? I already showed you around the village yesterday.
Man, I'm so stupid. I should have thought of something before coming here.
We wanted to thank you for all your help yesterday. You were so kind to us that we thought the least we can do is make your home safe from beasts. That's so nice of you. It makes me so happy. I guess this means I really was useful then. I'm so happy to hear that. It's been so long since I was useful. Oh, I know. I'll bless you with good fortune in return for, I'm sorry, I forgot how to cast blessings.
Aww.
And I don't have a tent, so there's nothing I can give you in return.
That's okay. I don't need anything else.
Really? Did I already give you some of the flowers I picked up this morning and just forget I did? Hermia? Tristra? Why don't you go back to the village without me?
I'm going to put up a boundary field to ward off other beasts, but it's going to take some time.
Oh, well, then we'll stay here until you're done, or until you're done too. Those beasts could come back at any time, so Hermia and I can protect you while you put up the boundary field.
No, that's okay. I can handle those beasts alone if it comes to that.
What do you mean, they're rider classes?
I see. Well, if you're sure, is it alright with you, Hermia?
If you say so, Mash.
Man, I didn't know Mash could put up boundary fields. Wow.
Alright, I'll see you two later then. Have fun with the other fairies. There, all done. You won't have to worry about beasts coming for you here anymore. Well, at least for a few weeks anyway. It's only Magecraft, not Sacrament, so it won't last forever. But at least for those few weeks, you'll be able to rest easy knowing you're safe. Magecraft? The mysterious power the Queen uses. I didn't know you could use it too, Mash. Is using Magecraft the hot new thing in the outside world now? Oh, I don't know about that. I mean, half my Magecraft is stuff I kind of taught myself.
Self-taught?
Besides, that stuff's kind of why I ran away in the first place. I mean, me, safe-brained with Magecraft like this? That's just not possible. Mash? I'm so sorry if I asked something I shouldn't have. Don't be. That was just a bad habit of mine. You're not the reason I was feeling sad just now. Do me a favor and just forget about it, please. More importantly, I think it might be better if you moved away from that village. It's not the other fairy's fault necessarily. You're just not a good fit for it. What about Salisbury? No way, they're very hostile to wind fairies with damaged wings there. How about Norwich? They say fairies and humans live side by side there. And who knows, if you find a human who's a good fit for you, maybe you'll even find a new purpose too. Thank you, but I'd rather stay here. Even if I did find a new purpose, I still wouldn't have a name. I think I must be exhausted. Nothing ever goes right for me, no matter what I do or what help I receive. I must have been so despondent with myself that I even forgot the most important thing of all. My name. So, I don't need to go anywhere. Here, nobody will be angry at my old self. Here, nobody will blame me for being a terrible fairy who wasted her life unable to fulfill her purpose.
Man, this is so depressing.
But I'm really sad. Not because the other fairies in the village hate me, but because I can't remember my own purpose anymore, or my name. I see. I guess not having a name really is a terrible thing. In that case, what about this? I just came up with the idea right now, but...
Well? From nameless fairy girl to fairy girl.
Thank you, Mash. This is the happiest I've ever been in my life. Oh, come on. Now you're just being nice. I see. Then I'm happy you're happy. Still, don't forget, this is our little secret. If the villagers find out, we'll both get in trouble.
I'm sure they say something like, even a village outcast has rules. Or Koma doesn't need any weird made-up customs. Oh, that's true. You might not know by looking at him, but Hama Boromio actually used to be an aide to Lady Aurora. Even now, he still admires the elegant fairy way of life. I really love that about him. I feel the same way. He might act all high and mighty, but I could tell right away that he really does care about the village. Oh gosh, I didn't realize we've been talking for so long. I better get back to the village. I'll come again tomorrow, okay? In the meantime, enjoy a peaceful night's sleep. I will. Bye-bye, Mash. See you tomorrow. See you tomorrow. Huh?
Oh!
Ow! What just happened? Why does my right eye hurt so much? Where's the puddle I can use for a mirror? There. Now, what's going on with my eye? Oh! I see. So I've turned dark. I guess I'm done for now. And just as something finally worked out for me too.
Aww, come on! So those black creatures we found are all nameless fairies who've... Well, I guess gone dark in her words, but... Oh no...
Morning. Good morning. It may be a shame to not have a banquet, but there's an upside. We got to bed earlier. So, what would you like to do today? If you don't have anything particular in mind, I'd like to go outside the village again myself.
I'm pretty hungry since we didn't have a banquet last night, so...
You're... hungry?
The giveaway.
Oh, good morning, Hermia. I'm sorry we couldn't give you the welcome you deserved last night. Fortunately, we should be able to make up for it tonight, so I do hope you're looking forward to it. Is something wrong? You don't seem like yourself.
Oh, I'm sorry, I didn't have anything to eat yesterday, so I'm just really hungry.
You're hungry because you didn't have anything to eat.
No. Here's where it all goes to shit. Oh, no.
Don't be ridiculous. Needing to eat is not like you're human or some...
Wait, you're serious?
You know, not you mentioned...
Ah, shit! Oh, no! Oh, no, we're exposed.
Now that you mention it... Oh my! I can't believe it! I never thought such a thing could be possible!
Hello, Boromia?
Everyone! I have big news! Hermia's human! We have an unregistered human with us!
Ah, shit!
Huh? Come on, it's too early for this nonsense! There's no way a human will be here of all...
I'm not joking! Take a closer look! It's not her wings that her wings were torn off. She's never had them to begin with. Hurry, come quick. We can't let her get out to the woods. Oh my goodness, I feel terrible about this. If only I'd realized it sooner. Now I'm even more sorry we didn't give you the kind of welcome you deserve, Hermia.
But don't worry, we're gonna make up for that right now with a really, really fun welcome party. Ah, what a wonderful day this is.
Let me see. Oh wow, you're right. Hermia really is human.
A human? A human, hooray! No wonder being around her made us all so happy.
Wait. Oh no.
This is great. No, we'll never have to worry about turning into Moors.
I'm in danger.
Oh no, I almost forgot. Be careful, Hermia. If you tell them you're hungry, I'm too late.
Are you human too? You are, aren't you? You don't have wings or command spells.
How about the guy with the harp? Is he human? No, wait, he's a fairy.
That's right, he didn't need anything. But who cares? Just put him with the others. It's easier that way.
Here, Hermia, Mash, and Tristram. Please, let me show you to the best spot in town. From now on, you'll be staying in a tent at the town square right in the middle of the village. Ah, there's so much to do, I don't know where to begin.
Welp.
It's been half a day since we were packed into this tent without so much as a word of explanation. How's the food they've been bringing you every hour, Hermia?
It's really good, but I'm not hungry anymore.
I'm popular.
My name's not Hermia!
We're not allowed to go out, and there are fairies guarding the outside or outside the tent in shifts. This isn't a welcome party. We're prisoners. Do you know why this happened to us, Mash?
Because Hermia is human. Thinking about it now, I was a little surprised myself to see how much you enjoy that fruit. I should have realized it then, but I still haven't seen many humans either.
Are you a fairy too, Mash?
I'm not entirely sure. I think I'm a fairy, but I also feel like I've been called a human-like at one point or another. But never mind that now. Right now, we need to focus on the situation at hand. You might think they're giving Hermia a warm reception now, but it's only going to heat up as time goes on.
Really? Even more than this?
Yes, really. You see, humans are very important sources of sustenance for us, or for fairies. Just having a human nearby makes them happier, almost like a mental balm. But these days, the human population is carefully managed by the Queen. Leaving lower class fairies without any humans for themselves. In fact, the fairies of this village wound up here because they didn't have humans. So, if nothing else, I'm sure they'll take good care of you, Hermia. But...
Yay, humans! Humans in the village! And not defective ones from the rebel army or the ones made for the queen. Real high quality humans! This is so great! We'll have to keep them safe so they don't get hurt. We'll have to figure out what they eat too. They say you can't just give them nuts and fruit. Humans like meat, right? So I have to go hunt some meat in the woods. Man, I'm so jealous of the guards. I can't wait till it's my turn. I just want to be near them. I just want to make them laugh, make them comfortable, make them cry. Oh, hold up there. I want to comb their hair, pull off their fingers, skin them alive. That went from 0 to 100 real fucking fast.
Too bad there's only two of them. No fair that Halibromia gets to decide who goes first. We'll never all get a piece of them that way. I just know I'm gonna miss out.
Oh, they want to rip us apart limb by limb, finger by finger, so that everyone has a piece of a human with them. Oh.
Yeah, we should just chop them into pieces and share with everyone.
You're human? Our human.
I'll take the left eye and you can have the right.
Yeah, yeah. I'll take the ring finger and take the middle one.
Yeah, that way everyone can get a piece.
Hey, what do you guys think you're doing? It's not your turn yet. Get back to your tents. Don't try anything with Hermia. You should have seen her on the athletic field. She used her head to score a goal. Her head? I've never seen anyone play football like that.
Bro.
She's a really entertaining lass. As long as she's around, we're gonna have more fun than we have.
Oh!
the fuck?
You talk too much, Doga. We don't need talkers.
We can't help ourselves. There's only two of them. Only two of them. Let's chop them up and share them with everyone. Chop them up and share them with everyone. But we're the only ones who are gonna get a share. The Fang Clan's gonna keep them all to ourselves. The Earth and Wind Clans talk too much too. Let's get them before they get us.
Is that fighting? I'm not sure exactly why, but the fairies seem to be fighting amongst themselves now. I suspect they have something to do with the different clans wanting to keep you all to themselves. The why is important now, though. You're obviously not safe here. You need to leave right away. What about the guards? Let's head inland. Once we get through this village, we can make our way to the hilly area. From there, there's a highway. And once you get there, we can think about where to go next. But first, yes, we do need to do something about the guards outside. Unfortunately, I doubt you and I alone would be any match for them. Remember, these fairies are all very powerful. There's no way a human could... Oh.
Oh good, you're still okay. Thank goodness. I noticed something was off in the village this morning, so I've been keeping an eye on things from afar. It's awful out there. First, everyone was yelling at each other, now they started fighting. Alboromio was doing his best to calm everyone down, but I don't think it worked.
Hey, keep an eye on things near the tent. Don't let anyone near it. I know we killed all the Wind Clan bastards, but there's still some fangs out there. Oh. Well, about that. About Alboromio. Ain't no way we're letting those veggie lovers take humans away from us. We gotta divide them both up evenly among the Earth Clan. Veggie lovers? Man. The moment we got exposed, man, like... Okay then.
Haunt Farm. It's no use, Hermia. They're not the fairies you knew anymore. They're being driven wild by their bloodlust. Come with me. I can get you out through the weak stitching in the cloth where I snuck in. You do want to get out into the woods, right? Then please, trust me. I know a way inland. Now come on, hurry!
Those are Earth Clan fairies. They look nothing like they used to. Ah, how this saddens me. What do I see now but the devil?
It's not that Tristram, you can't play your harp right now. He'll hear us.
Huh. Hey, did you hear something? Maybe one of the Wind Clan bastards survived. Kesley, Gum, go check it out. The rest of us will head to the tent. Crush your legs first. That'll keep him from running. Ah, crap, we gotta get out of here now. Oh, I'm so sorry. My fingers moved before I realized what I was doing. Anyway, yes, we need to get out of the village. I'll bring up the rear.
This way, everyone. Please follow me.
Aw, please don't tell me she's just gonna die here.
Yes, this is it. Once you cross those three hills, you'll be far enough inland. Are you okay? I know we've been running nonstop.
I'm okay. Well, I'm managing.
Indeed. There were two fairies after us, but it seems we lost them after we crossed that first hill.
They must have gotten lost in the fog. I guess all that time you spent living outside the forest must have paid off. Thank you for showing us the way. You've been a huge help. But are you sure about this? Now that you've helped us escape, doesn't that mean you can never go back to that village? Yes, it does. But please, don't worry about that, Mash. My home is safe now, thanks to you. Now please, don't worry about me. You need to leave the forest as soon as possible. Go, quickly, before the villagers find you. I have to put more distance between you and them.
What's that mark on your face?
What mark? Ah, I can smell the wind now. It smells just like good old, salsaberry earth. Soon we'll be out of the woods, not much longer. Beautiful Britain, you haven't changed a bit. You're just as I remember from when I had a name. Almost there. Just a little more.
I see a slope up ahead. That must be the last hill.
Once we cross it, we'll be out of these woods. Thank you. We could never have made it this far without a... What's wrong? Oh my gosh, are you okay? Are you hurt? Why don't we take a little... Shut up! Just shut up! Don't touch me! Don't touch me! It hurts, it hurts, it hurts so damn much! It's been hurting for all these hundreds of years I've spent alone. It can force me to do things I couldn't do. Hundreds of years of endless frustration. Nobody ever helped me before. Nobody ever even noticed me before. So why'd you have to be so kind of, or had to be kind of me now when it's already too late? Idiots! You're idiots! Have you really not figured it out yet? I tricked you! The only reason I brought you here, out here is so I can keep you all to myself. Why else would I be doing this? Why did I...
Oh...
Get ready, Tristram. Hermia. She's not a fairy anymore. She's Moors now. Just the thing that can no longer speak or listen. It's a dark sludge that fouls the earth just by existing. It is Britain's curse. And it is death to fairies.
Well. Alright, we gotta put her down. Holy, that's a lot of health.
ひどわが弓の切なる曲を死をもってあがないは殺戮をもって収束をフェイルノートはっ声の無駄でひねり潰します。
Curse and disastrous curse. Oh yeah, wait. I just noticed that she's still named Mash too. Tristram's doing his best. I think we got her, but... Be careful, Hermia. She's not done yet. But she's not trying to attack anymore. Is she... trying to tell us something?
Pardon me.
Oh.
I hope you don't mind. I didn't want to make you three put her out of her misery. As I know the moors well, I thought I should be the one to do what was necessary.
That rapier strike came from behind us like the wind. There's something familiar about them.
Hit him!
Sorry about that. You're free now. May you find peace in your next life.
No way! You're
a good, trustworthy, worthy fellow.
Hey there, Kirby. Nice to meet you. Sorry it took so long to get here. Then again, I guess that's pretty confusing too, judging from the look on your face.
The king doesn't typically introduce himself, but none of my attendants are here, so I suppose I don't have a choice.
I am Oberon, a heroic spirit summoned here by humanity. I'm the one and only servant in all this Lostbelt who's destined to help you.
Most people know me as Oberon, the Fairy King. What do you think? Pretty cool, right? Alright, okay then. So, let's see, are we gonna kind of clear up the confusion about MASH?
Most people know me as Oberon the Fairy King. What do you think? Pretty cool, right?
That's right, my name's Kirby, and yours is...
Indeed, you are Kirby, the Master of Chaldea. And I am Tristan, Knight of the Bewitched Bow, and the Child of Sadness. At last I finally remember everything. As for you, MASH, your name's not really MASH.
Oberon, but not Merlin?
But Merlin?
Oh, I'm sorry, you're just not exactly who I was expecting. But you look so much like someone I was thinking about that it threw me off for a moment. Ahem, at any rate, I remember who I am now too. My name is Caster. Artoria Caster. Oh, well that's kind of a mouthful, isn't it? Really, Caster was just my name in the village I'm from, so please call me Artoria.
I'm relieved to see you got your names back. Now we better hurry, or you'll get caught in that fog again. Go on, get going. See those trees over there? That's your goal. First, you should see what Britain is really like. After that, we'll have plenty to talk about.
That's true, we need to get out of these woods.
I agree. Let's go, Kirby. It's time you saw Twilight Island home of so many fairies. The utopia of wind, earth, and life, blessed by song and rain. The Isle of Britain.
Taking me by the hand. That is kind of pretty. Oh! Oh, we can kind of like look out into the distance with artillery and stuff. And obviously it's different depending whether you have male or female MC and stuff. That's cool. Oh, finally! We're done with chapter one! Fragment?
Meanwhile, several days after she got separated from Kirby, the girl managed to make it out of the Nameless Woods on her own, ahead of the others. Was it the difference in her innate servant abilities? Simply a stroke of good luck.
Neither, in fact. She was simply swept along by a Morse current and unceremoniously spat out elsewhere.
Oh! Wait! She's back in her... Oh, shit! She's back in her regular... or in her other outfit.
The outcome speaks for itself. Deprived of her strength, her equipment in pieces, she can only collapse by the highway. This is bad. Very, very bad. If she stays here too long... Fairy peddler. See, what'd I tell you? I knew there'd be one or two around this time of year. Check it out, a premium wind fairy. This will keep us fed the whole winter. Joe be easy pickings for the slave hunters who prey on fairies who wander out of the woods. Oi, get a call on her before she wakes up. I don't know who she is, but it won't matter once you sell her. We'll make a bundle and she'll get a nice warm bed to, and someone to keep her company. Oh my god. Now that's what I call a win-win. Ah, a wolf! There's a wolf here! Oh, a white wolf. But fortunately, fate had other plans for her. No wonder she's my favorite. That fluffy guy next to her is, Sage Grimm, the White Fang. Those thugs won't get near her, not with him around. Ah, crap, she's awake. And she looks really strong, too. We're dead!
Who are you? No, wait, why was I collapsed on the ground?
Whew, she doesn't remember anything. Hey there, young lady, we're just, you know... a group of kindly caretakers. It's our job to help any fairies who collapse on the side of the road. Yeah, that's it, we're here to help you. Now go on, get in our cart. It's the latest model from Norwich. It's way better than walking. One of us pulls while the other two smile. That way the other two can relax, so only one has to work. But hey, don't worry, you're a valued guest. We never make you pull the cart. Now, what are we gonna call you? Say, what do you think of Annis Brothers? Doesn't that sound like a great name for her? You mean we're not going with Urchin Lady like usual? Well, I guess a little change of pace wouldn't hurt. Sounds good to you, Annis. Now go on, try to stand up. Here, hold on to me if you need. Besides, you don't want to be laying on the ground too long or the giant goggy caterpillars eat you right up.
Oh, okay. Thank you.
Oh, well. Whoa, what's it all that metal? She's got an iron shield, iron armor, and what's this? A canister? Damn, you think she's one of the Queen's Knights, seeing how she's got all these weapons? You guys sure this is a good idea? What if the Queen kills us? Ah, you're still a big scaredy cat, aren't you, Wag? Don't worry about it. Even if she is one of the Queen's Knights, who cares? Doesn't matter if she can't remember anything. Yeah, what's gonna happen when she doesn't even know her own name? And she doesn't have a place to call home, what's wrong with taking her to a new one? As our merchandise, of course. The three fairies exchange a knowing look and cackle. And so, she and all her things wind up on the cart with not a clue as to who she is. The cart begins heading north towards Gloucester, beginning another separate journey. But all that aside... Hey, that wolf's still following us. What do we do, brothers? You really don't want to mess with his like. They say if you kill one, you become a Morse. I guess we'll just have to let him tag along, too. Maybe we... Wait. Oh. Wait. Okay. Guess we'll just have to let him tag along, too. Maybe we can even sell him off along with the girl. Don't worry, these fairies won't be having much luck as her... Wait, much luck as long as her intimidating furry friend is around.
Alright. Now we get to chapter 2. Beautiful, isn't it? This is the center of the British Lostbelt. See that super ominous castle-looking thing over there? That's Camelot. These days, Britain is divided into North and South regions, and Camelot sits between them. Most people live here, in the southern central area. Four main cities in this region are Salisbury, the Great Cathedral, Norwich, the nearest port town. Let's not go there, it is a silly place. Gloucester, the city of fashion, and Oxford, the great dining hall. Each city is run by the head of a fairy clan. Sorry to interrupt, but do you know where Mash and Da Vinci are? Oh, I see. So there were others from Chaldea with you. I'm very sorry, but you're the only one I managed to find. And as you can see, it's just me right now, so tracking you down was the best I can do. Well, that leads nicely to my next point. Can you tell me what this Mashery looks like? As long as I know what she looks like, I can have Blanca look for her. Blanca, who is that? Didn't you say you were alone? Oh, right, here, let me introduce you. Moth. Pretty cute, right? I talk with her a lot. I guess you could call her my friend. Anyway, she's very neat, very smart, and above all, she's a hard worker. If anyone can track down Mash, she can. Okay, now that that's settled, how about we start by sharing what we know, what we all know with one another? You tell me your story, and I'll tell you mine. And you know the rest. I see, so you've conquered 5 Lost Spells thus far. And while you weren't originally planning to come to Britain, you, Mash, Leonardo, and Tristan, wound up coming here to investigate this collapse. But then, after the 4 of you landed here, you got separated in the Nameless Woods. That's unfortunate. No, I'm sorry I couldn't be of more help. I had no idea you weren't the only one lost. If only I'd been more attentive back then, maybe I could have tracked down Mash and Leonardo as well. But I was so excited about fighting you that I forgot all about everything else. So then you were the one I saw before, or saw at the beach before I lost consciousness? For the time being, there's one thing we can and should check. Mash is her contracted servant, right? Then she have a magical energy connection with her. If it's still active, then we'll at least know she's alive, even if we don't know where she is. How about it? Can you check on that for us? Oh, she's alive. What a relief. Great. Then all we have to do now is find her. And Leonardo's a servant too, right? Then I'm sure she's still alive and kicking too. Fortunately, the fairies here can't tell the difference between their fellow fae folk and servants. So as long as they're not human, they shouldn't be in too much danger. So let's just stay calm and trust them to handle themselves. Next, Artoria, is there something you'd like to say to me?
No, not right now anyway. Honestly, I'm still trying to wrap my head around everything I just heard about Chaldea, proper human history, the Lost Belts, and so on. Although, getting back to servants, heroic spirits, is that like a human turning into a fairy after they die? And you said both you and Tristan are servants yourselves?
That's right. If you want to know more about heroic spirits and servants, I'm sure Kirby there will be happy to fill you in on the way. Between a resident of this Lost Belt like you and the master from proper human history who is a guest in this world, you two should be able to catch each other up on almost everything. On the way, you said. Does that mean you have a destination in mind, Oberon?
I do indeed. When you're trying to track someone down, a big city's your best bet.
Besides, you and Kirby both need to get used to the way things work here in Fairy Britain. So our next stop is Salisbury, the biggest city in the south. There we'll find food, clothing, shelter, everything we need, really. It's just about a full day's walk from here. I know you've been up all night, but do you think you can make the trek?
Well, we don't have time to sit around and rest.
No, let's not be hasty. I know how you must feel, but like I said, now is the time to take it easy. Remember, Britain's a big place. If you keep pushing yourself so hard, you'll burn out you'll burn out long before you find Mash. Don't worry. You can tell she's okay because you're her master, right? Well, my own intuition is telling me she's perfectly safe. Or safe too. And I'm the Fairy King, so that really means something. Let's start with Salisbury, and figure out the rest from there.
Salisbury, huh? What should I do? It might be kind of dangerous to go back now. What else? I can't leave Kirby to fend for herself. Plus, I don't care what this Avalon guy says. He really seems a lot like Merlin.
Aw.
Would it be okay if I came along too, Kirby? I know I mistakenly went by Mash's name for a while there. But I want to know more about you and about, oh right, proper human history.
Sorry. I just assumed you'd be coming with us.
Right, of course not. Oh gosh, what am I even saying? Of course you wouldn't want a country bumpkin like me to tackle huh? Oop. You're shaking my hand again? Does that mean it's okay?
Of course. I'm glad to have you with us, Artoria.
Yes. Now that's a lovely friendship. I was definitely on pins and needles back in Cornwall, but it seems not interfering was the right choice after all. In theatrical terms, I believe this is the part where we say, now that the actors are in place, the real story can begin. Now they alone won't be enough. The Child of Prophecy alone won't get there in time. So we need both to defeat the mighty Morgan.
Oh wait, hold on, I'm getting... there's more DMs I actually didn't check out yet. Okay, hold on. I need to check some more stuff real quick. Sorry for the delay real quick. Let me see. Oh, there's actual patch notes for Star Rail with the recent update? Oh, hold on. Oh, there's a new area too. Oh, cool. So that was the event. Oh wait, permanently available after the update. Oh, that's a permanent side quest that comes out. Okay. Oh wait, check-in rewards? Log in every day during the event. Oh, right. Actually, hold on. Let me go reboot Star Rail real quick. Although I'm gonna mute the volume since I'm not gonna show it on screen right now. Hold on. I need to log on real quick to double check some stuff I need to grab. Also, where's the rebalance that was going on in Star Rail? Oh, wait. Adjust the status icons for all type resistance. In-game effects remain unchanged. So aside from that, adjustments will be made to other in-game aspects. Adjust the tutorial.
Combat.
Aww. Hold on real quick. Let's see what else is there. There it is. Okay, I need to claim that. Oh, the previous one was a permanent deal. Oh. Okay, was that everything I needed to go over? Okay. I got all my stuff from Sarana. Let's go. Where is Mordred? Here we go. Pop in the CE. All right, let's go. The prophecy was true. That girl is our star of hope. She will be our salvation. She will be our path to forgiveness. She's our savior, who drifted to our shores with a ship full of treasure. She's the one who will hear the voice of paradise and chant the promised name. Ah, dear Artoria. May you grow to the age of 16, healthy and strong. May the Queen's soldiers never find you. One day you will go on a journey to ring the six bells and save all of Britain. A journey to welcome our true king, Gloucester, Salisbury, Oxford, Norwich, Orkney. We may not know where the sixth bell is, but we're confident you'll find it. The Staff of Selection has chosen you. You are Fairy Britain's only hope. Now go on, hurry, hurry, hurry. Hurry and greet your 16th birthday. We have complete faith in you. Wait. The village is done for. The executioner squads are here. Hold your head high. Grip your staff tight. Now is the time to begin your journey, Artoria. Remember, no matter what anyone says, you're unquestionably the child of prophecy. You're the spitting image of her.
I'm sorry I'm so weak. I'm sorry I can't live up to your expectations.
Wait. What the heck?
I'll do my best. I promise. As much as I can. As I can.
Smack, smack. Hey, I get it. There aren't many things cozier than a campfire.
Oh no, was I asleep?
Wait. Oh, they accidentally put an extra space and messed up the sentence. Just remember, no.
I just remember Tristan playing his harp and then...
How this saddens me. I was merely trying to soothe your exhaustion. But I cannot help but notice you don't seem to care for my music or my liege. Wait. Artoria. Oh my god.
I'm sorry. I'm just not used to hearing music. But it really did help me fall asleep peacefully. I'd love it if you played again when it's bedtime.
Ouch, you wound me, Maid Artoria.
No bard wants to be told his music puts people to sleep.
Hey, you can't blame her. We've been walking non-stop nearly all day. Well, we're all exhausted.
That's why we're camping out here tonight before making our way to Salisbury tomorrow morning.
Artoria, you can put up a bounded field to keep wild animals away, right? I'd hate to ask since I know you're sleepy, but would you mind?
Wait, hold on real quick. Let me just do a thing real quick.
Oh, yes, of course. Okay, I'll be back soon.
Now then. I know we told Artoria that proper human history is like a parallel world to Britain, but of course that's not the whole truth, is it? The truth is, proper human history is the rightful historical timeline, and it's fundamentally incompatible with this world of fairy Britain. As Chaldea, you have to erase the Lost Bus to ensure humanity's future. And now you're trying to come up with a way to tell Artoria this without hurting her too badly. I know it's wrong to hide that, but... I see. I suppose you have betrayed the people of 5 Lost Bloods already. Damn, I usually pride myself on being an excellent conversationalist. But even I'm having trouble coming up with the right words to heal the wounds in your heart. So for now, the best I can do is offer some words of consolation. It's okay, Kirby. This Lost Bell won't fall by your hand. Remember, it's falling apart on its own. If anything, I'd say you're doing it a favor.
Favor?
Yes, indeed. Human history simply could not ever prosper in this version of Britain. It's a flawed world that was always destined for destruction. History took a dreadfully wrong turn here. The only problem is that it's threatening to take proper human history down with it when it all goes to pot. That's why guys like us from proper human history have to do whatever we can to save it. And that means defeating the one who's been ruling it from on high for 2,000 years. High Queen Morgan. Hold on. Did you say Morgan? As in, that Morgan. Yep, that Morgan. The same one who proved to be King Arthur's ultimate Achilles heel in proper human history, even after he united all of Britain. The extraordinary witch who lured King Arthur into countless traps so she could take Camelot for herself. And the mother of Mordred, the treacherous knight. The child of King Arthur who proved to be his downfall. She's the one who ultimately destroyed Britain. And here, she's Fairy Britain's ruler, and she'll bring it all to ruin. Let's see, I think you Chaldeans would probably refer to her as this Lost Blood's king. King Arthur's arch enemy, here in this Lost Blood. Anyway, based on everything you told me, it sounds like Morgan's behind the outside world anomaly. So as long as you can defeat her, that should end the threat to proper human history. After that, you can just leave this place to its fate. Whether it falls apart or pulls itself back together, you won't need to feel bad about it. Look over there. What was it a Lost Bell needs to survive again? A Tree of Emptiness? Well, I'm guessing that world tree, the giant ash over there beyond the sea, is it? And as you can see, it's been dead for a long time. So this Lost Bell definitely hasn't got long left. Was it ever on fire at any point? Oh yeah, now that you mention it, it was. It went up in flames not too long ago, then died out again just as quickly as it started. I wonder what that was all about anyway. Anyway, that's enough talk for tonight. Don't want to overdo the info dump. So even if you don't remember anything else we talked about tonight, at least remember this. Defeat High Queen Morgan, ruler of Fairy Britain. Nice and simple, right? As for the rest, I'll tell you once we reach Salisbury. Once you see a Fae City for yourself, I think you have a much better handle on what life in Britain is like. Whoops, sorry to interrupt, but we got monsters.
Get ready to fight, Kurt. Ah, come on, I can't just pull the moss and bullshit on me.
Oh, okay. I'm so sorry. I accidentally skipped a couple steps when I was making the battlefield. And I ended up summoning a pack of wild birds by mistake. Can you help me out, please?
Bro, of all the times I have arbitrary ass fights, Atari's like, whoops, oops, all monsters.
Huh, I never thought the day would come when my liege would come beg me for help. I'm sorry, I keep forgetting she's not the King Arthur I knew. Oh, this is so embarrassing.
Oops, more wyverns, pretty much.
Oh, right, Tristan used to be.
Hey, here they come. Be careful, Kirby. Britain's beasts are not to be trifled with. You know, I kind of want to get a snack after this fight. I'm actually getting kind of hungry with all the reading. Actually, what do I want for snack right now? Maybe I just go grab some cookies.
Yay, we won! No, we trounced them. Man, that feels good. Ah, this makes me happy. That was the first battle I've won handily since being summoned. Hey, Artoria, are you actually pretty, competitive? Oh, no, it's nothing really. I'm glad I was able to contribute. I see. So you're already strong enough to handle a murder of night crows without much trouble, hmm? Very nice. That's even better than I was expecting. Also, wait, did I just see a spider?
No? Hold on. I don't want to get jumped by a bug again like in the last stream. Because, like, when I was in the middle of, like, what was it? I think it was when I was in the middle of the Darkest Dungeon stuff, right? Last night? Like, there was a bug that crawled, like, on the underside of my arm and then just bit me when I, like, rotated it to take a look. And I had to scramble to find, like, the nearest, like, a napkin I had at my table to, like, find the bug and stop it from, like, hiding away somewhere. And also, it looked different from the usual bugs I'd see, like, here and there. Like, instead of, like, it being like, light brownish or whatever, it was, like, it looked black in appearance. And I'm like, wait. Like, I don't know why this bug looked darker than, like, the other ones I've seen. I'm like, huh. But yeah, like, I don't know what's going on with, like, the bugs and shit. Like, man, I kind of want to do like a deep clean of my room, but that's just gonna take like actual days, with like how much furniture I need to move around, how much like random books and other stuff I have lying around that I need to reorganize. You know, now that I look at it, I would really love to have like a huge bookshelf for all the game cases and books and other stuff, and a display case to actually house all my, like, figures, and maybe an actual table, proper table to, like, put all my plushes down in one place, because my plushes are, like, scattered around the room because I have, like, nowhere else to put them all in one convenient spot. But that
is a room improvement project and whatever that I do not have the time for. Nor the money to get all the stuff I'd actually want, because I don't want to spend that recklessly.
Tristan, your bow may not be particularly strong, but its range is exceptional. You're clearly well suited for battles against large groups. With you on our side, I bet we can win no matter how outnumbered we may be. And as for you, Artoria, you're much more of a wild card than you look. Is that strange tool of yours handmade? A rare weapon like that would be very effective against an opponent who's never seen it before, especially as a distraction. And above all, your summons are fascinating, Kirby. Temporarily summoning heroic spirits to aid in battle, huh? I had no idea it was such a flexible and powerful way to fight. Human magecraft doesn't tend to work very well against fairies, but summoning heroic spirits is definitely an exception. The only problem with it is how long you can last given the incredible demands on your stamina, magical energy, and sheer luck. Plus, it seems like the longer the battle lasts, the more of a toll it takes on you. But as long as you're careful about that, you should be able to handle anyone, fairy or not. Wait a moment. Human magecraft? You can use magecraft, Kirby? Just barely, thanks to my missing code, but yep. Oh gosh, I'm sorry, I was just a little taken aback. You see, magecraft isn't really used much in Britain. Basically, fairies perform sacraments without any help from basic magecraft spells and mystic codes. So magecraft is considered unnecessary at best and, only practiced by weirdos at worst.
Hey! Call me weird.
In fact, to be totally blind, if you tell people you use magecraft here, they tend to look at you all funny and ask why'd you go to all that trouble. I see. You do have a point. Fairies simply have no need of magecraft. And since this Britain is a land dominated by fairies, that would mean magecraft is effectively worthless here. So why do you use it then, Artoria?
Oh man, after everything I just said, you really went there, huh?
Now, it was only an honest question, Artoria. You know she didn't mean anything by it, right? Anyway, you don't have to answer it if you'd rather not. As for you, Kirby, I suggest you wait for a better time before bringing this up again. Anyway, I think we might have gotten distracted from our main purpose. Now that we've gotten this nice camp set up, we should use it to get a good night's rest. I'm sure there's more you'd like to know about, Kirby Artoria, but why don't we save that for tomorrow? Fortunately, there are none of the Queen's soldiers, no Moors, and no rebel army around here. And once we wake up in the morning, it's only another hour's walk to Salisbury, where we'll be able to have a much more in-depth conversation. After all, if you're going to have a fun discussion, you should save it for a nice, relaxing place, right?
Oh, that's the, Actually, what other things can we see around here? Wait, is that like a giant bird's nest? Giant seashell. Wait, what's that swirling? Above there. Aww. Is that a honeycomb? Swampy area? Like the Deadwoods or whatever?
Alright, so let me be right back real quick. I'm gonna grab a snack. I am really getting hungry for some reason.
Oh, did I say I was hungry? Hold on, I never saw that. That's
good. Okay, be right back for one moment.
Alright, I'm back. Sorry, that took a little bit. I had to splash some cold water on my face because once I actually walked out of my room, oh my god, I was like, man, it's actually pretty cold. Unlike my room where it's like getting more like a greenhouse again. Just warming up by the minute as like my computer just stays on in a room with not so great circulation. But yeah, I got some cookies. Well, basically just like 1.5 cookies. Did we really just sum up history all the way up until- what the fuck? And that's the gist of the world's history up until, 2017.
Wow, so other worlds really do exist. England, Scotland, Ireland-
I don't think they're entirely new worlds, but- Wow, the world of England sounds great!
And you said there are other countries beyond the Isle too? Like, France and Italy?
Oh, okay, no, she says country. It's just like, the order... It's just like... When she says that quickly followed up by the other countries, it's like she's regarding them as different worlds. I'm like, hold up here.
So wait, let me reread that. And you said there are other countries beyond the Isle too? Like, France and Italy? I can't even imagine so many different countries and cultures and people. It sounds like you come from a really wonderful world. Britain without the fairies, huh? That sounds like a nice change of pace.
Well, from where Kirby is sitting, I imagine she finds this Britain full of fairies to be quite the change of pace.
Oh, I just noticed the moth on his finger just disappeared.
I do have to correct you on one thing, though. It's not that there aren't any fairies at all in proper human history where Kirby comes from. While mystics have definitely faded since the AD era began, fairies are still around. Though, of course, there are far fewer of them, and don't reveal themselves to humans much. Heck, I'm a fairy heroic spirit myself.
I don't think of it, Elbron. Aren't you from...
Midsummer's Night Dream, right? Written by William Shakespeare, England's greatest playwright. It may well be one of the most famous stories about fairies. It's basically about love. It's basically about a love, a square, between humans.
Wait. Love square?
Alright then. But two of the most important characters are Oberon, the King of Fairies, and his Queen Titania. In the story, Oberon wants Titania to give him one of her pages. So he hatches a plan involving a potion that will cause the drinker to fall in love with the first living thing they see upon awakening. But two humans end up taking it by mistake, causing them to forget about the person they love and mistakenly believe they're fated to be with someone else.
Oh no.
Well, without going into much detail, it all wraps up nicely in the end. It's a sort of comedy of errors that focused on love and miscommunication you'd see anywhere. But unfortunately for me, it became so popular that it kept being retold for generations. Thanks to that, the word fairy is now synonymous with a mischievous Puck and narrow-minded King Oberon. So at least in one sense, I might be the most famous fairy in the world. If you never read it before, you should give it a shot once you get back to Caldea. It doesn't paint the most flattering picture of me, but unfortunately, but never mind that. And just to be clear, I swear I wasn't trying to make trouble, okay? I'm just a plot device, really. Only there to get the romantic hijinks rolling.
So then, does that mean you're a fictional character, Oberon? Is it even possible for someone as vaguely defined as that to become a servant?
Well, do we have a thing to tell you, Artoria?
No, it isn't. While Shakespeare's A Midsummer's Night Dream is indeed how he is best known, Legends of Oberon, the Fairy King, have existed in Europe since ancient times. Perhaps most notably, there's a poem about him from the 15th century, well before Shakespeare's time, where he is described as a king of fairies who can use any magic, or wait, who can use magic to make any wish come true. Really, I didn't know about that one. The point is, the character was inspired by an existing model, and that model must have become the base for my servant form. Which came first, who knows? Just another version of the chicken and egg problem. What about Titania then? Oh, since she's all Shakespeare, she's all Shakespeare. There are no legends in fairy history about of anyone by that name. The name Titania probably came from the Titans of Greek mythology. The Oberon in A Midsummer's Night Dream is pretty self-centered after all. You can never find a lady who would tolerate him, so Shakespeare had to make one up. But I digress, sorry for wasting our time. Salisbury is just up ahead. Don't worry about the guards, I'll handle them. All you three have to do is stay quiet, okay? Or stay quiet. It's okay. My face is basically a free pass into the city. Alright, one more thing. Do not tell them your names. If they ask, and you can't avoid answering, make something up. You don't need anyone else finding out that you're human, and you never know who might be listening. Hold on, isn't it dangerous to lie to fairies? I heard their eyes can see through falsehoods. If so, shouldn't we try to avoid lying wherever possible? Oh, don't worry, the fairies here don't have powers like that. I don't know if they lost them all, or lost them thanks to all this prosperity, or if they threw them away in order to be prosperous, but either way, they definitely can't tell truth from lies anymore. The only way you can tell them if you, the only way you can tell if you're dealing with a good person or not is when everything's said and done. Okay, or how else could someone as evil as Morgan have stayed at the top of this world for so long? He's got a point. That's a huge cathedral. Wow, that really is a huge cathedral. Ah, how this gladdens me. The air here is very different from Cornwall. There may be fairies everywhere we turn here, but I don't sense anything dangerous about them. They all seem happy and full of good cheer. Is there some sort of festival taking place today or something? No, this is just life in Salisbury. It's the only free city in all of Britain. There are about 200,000 people living in Salisbury. Some are wind, earth, and fang fairies. Some are fairies who emerge spontaneously from nature, and some are even independent humans. Independent humans? Humans who have won their freedom, and now belong to no one but Britain itself. I was hoping to tell you about that aspect of life here once things have settled down, but I guess it was bound to come up sooner or later. And since the Great Cathedral is here too, this seems a good place as any to get into it. You Caldans may have thought there were no humans in this Lostbelt, but strictly speaking, that's not true. Humans do exist here, they're just not at the top of the hierarchy. Here, they use as tools to enrich fairy society. In proper human history terms, they're essentially slaves. Didn't you think there was something strange about the city? It's wrong, twisted, unseemly. Now that you mention it, the idea of a fairy city does seem wrong. Exactly! Fairies are supposed to live in harmony with nature. Even when they form communities, it's always forest children with forest children and stone children gathering under the same great mother. They were always just the divided spirits of the planet, who never possessed a culture of their own. But as you can see, Fairy Britain has become a place where fairies imitate human society. For about 14,000 years, fairies here have raised humans like cattle. In that time, they used humans' innate creativity as entertainment, which in turn allowed them to flourish. Fairies live long lives, and they require no sustenance whatsoever. Since there's nothing they can't do, they never change, they never try anything new. In contrast, humans have countless weaknesses. They live short lives, their injuries don't heal, they need food to survive, they can easily be killed by wild beasts. So naturally, humans came up with all sorts of things that would allow them to survive and flourish in spite of all those weaknesses. I'm guessing the fairies found that kind of human thinking to be absolutely fascinating. It was like finding a shiny new toy. So they began keeping humans as livestock, followed by superficially copying their culture with cities like this one. They completely ignored the substance behind human agriculture, architecture, and other various fields of study, instead only imitating it at the most basic superficial level. Anything they couldn't copy manually, they fudged with magical energy. That cathedral over there is the worst offender. Fairies have no gods and no religion. And there's no actual point in making the cathedral. They just thought it was fun. That's Fairy Britain's culture, and that's how they treat humans. So basically, they ripped off human culture. Well, yes, I guess you could put it that way. Still, as a fairy myself, I can understand how things got to this point. While they definitely took it too far, it makes sense that they get like this in a world where humans are endangered. Both in proper human history and in this lost bond, humans are fairies' favorite source of luxury entertainment. This land came to be known as Fairy Britain when fairies began regulating humans at a societal level. Oh god. It's also the key political policy of High Queen Morgan, your enemy. Huh, you guys are going to fight Morgan? Yep, or at least that's the current plan. Isn't that right, Kirby? I still have a good handle. I know about fighting yet. I still have a good handle on the situation here, but I do know we need to meet her. But first, we need to find my other two companions. Oh right, we do, don't we? First things first, and all that. Why don't we start with the pub? There are always people coming and going in pubs. Some of them may know something useful. Why'd you stop? Is something wrong? Kirby, you've helped me out a lot and I really do appreciate it, but... what should I do if she's going to fight High Queen Morgan? It'd only complicate things if I stuck around. I wanted to stay with her until she found Mash, but... it'd probably be better to go our separate ways here. I can't take the phrase separate ways like seriously anymore because of freaking Resident Evil 4. So that's how it is. Ahem, by the way, Artoria. Do you know what they do to humans in the city they catch without their owners? They're captured as ranch escapees and sent to New Darlington. New Darlington? As in, Darlington, the National Slaughterhouse Theater? Ah. Taiwa? That's horrible. Wait, isn't Salisbury supposed to be a free city? The head of the Wind Clan runs this place, right? Surely they wouldn't lie anything, they wouldn't do anything so horrid. Not necessarily. Not even the head of the Wind Clan can defy the High Queen. So it would definitely be to our advantage to have as many trusted collaborators with us as we can. Kirby still doesn't know right from left here, and on top of that, she's human. Without an owner to watch over her, it'll be the Nameless Woods all over again. I do it myself, but since I'm obviously noble, even royal, it would strain credulity if I try to claim a human of unknown origins as one of my attendants. But you, on the other hand, would be a perfect fit for Kirby. And don't worry, I'm not asking you to stay with her forever, just while we're in Salisbury. You'd prefer that over being alone too, right, Kirby? I guess you're right, being alone in Britain these days would make you more likely to attract suspicion from the authorities. But what about Tristan? Couldn't he pretend to be Kirby's owner? He probably could, but Tristan knows just as little about Fairy Britain as Kirby. It wouldn't take much questioning from one of the clan guards to expose the facade. I wouldn't go that route unless we had no other choice. But if I had a human attendant, that would mean I'd have to be an upper-class fairy.
Oh my god, wait, her... her like, nervous, blushing expression. Oh my god.
Which would also make me Kirby's owner and... It would just be pretend. Or were you actually hoping to make her your pet?
Okay, hold on real quick. Wait, did I? Like, I think I need to check OBS or something. I think I saw something weird go on. We good? Okay. Because, like, again, like, I've been having these weird problems over the past couple months where my OBS windows would just flash or flicker. Not that it affects anything directly on the stream, but, like, I would see, like, my OBS windows just flicker all of a sudden. Wait, Twitch has a had a massive fart for you? Wait, did something happen with the Twitch chats? Like, was it all, like, disconnecting or something weird? Huh.
No, I couldn't. Pretend is fine. I'm still much too young for that.
Oh wait, none of the streams would load for you? Oh! Wait, was anyone else having issues with streams not loading? Cause yeah, I didn't notice anything was going on, so... Yeah, Twitch is... Oh man.
Great. Then it's settled.
Kirby, Artori's going to be your owner for a while. It'll be the safest way to travel here. Think you can play along?
Oh my god. Oh my god. Her blushing smile. She knows she wants it, but she wants to like go with this. But oh my god.
Don't worry, I actually have some acting experience.
Okay, if you're sure you want me to do this, then I'll do it. Besides, we've come this far together, so I certainly don't mind traveling together a little more. In fact, looking on the bright side, this is actually making one of my childhood dreams come true.
Oh, what dream would that be?
The same dream every fairy growing up in the country has, joining the ranks of upper-class city folk.
Oberon?
Huh.
Hey there, my good Salisburyans! How are you all this fine day? That's right, it is I, Oberon, the Fairy King of Autumn Woods, the missionary of peace, flowers, and fairy tales, here to grace you with my boisterous presence.
Gotcha.
Hey, Oberon! Glad to see you're doing well. Nice to have you back in Salisbury again. Just make sure you don't put anything on your tab today, you hear? Oberon, coming to day drink was a good idea. Boy, when are you paying back the money I lent you?
I said to thank you for your help the other day, Oberon. Your advice really got the trees in my backyard to settle down.
The trees to settle down?
I'm still waiting for you to pay me back, though.
Okay, I think I might be seeing a trend here.
Lovely, Oberon. You have some time to spare, right? You simply must attend our tea party today. I'm still waiting for you to pay me back, though.
There's the poor little prince with a 10,000 year tab. Don't worry, I'll cover this round. I'm still waiting for you to pay me back, though.
We all cut that out. Stop pointing out how popular I am.
I'm here with someone important, or with some important friends today. Save the money talk for another time, alright?
Ha. We know. Don't worry, we're all just joking. You've enriched our lives way more than the Queen's banknotes could ever. We're happy to treat you.
Was that about a 10,000 year tab?
So you're poor, even though you call yourself a king?
Well, yes, my finances are a little lean just now, and bluntly, I'm flat broke. What do you expect when I was summoned to Fairy Britain? All I had on me was this cloak. I woke up in a forest piled high with dead leaves and literally nothing to my name. Usually in a situation like that, I'd be too bummed to do anything but wait for help from proper human history. But since I arrived first, I knew there were things I needed to take care of. Fairies thrive on what they find interesting, so I went around putting on shows in the various cities here. I sang songs, riled up crowds, told fairy tales, entertained housewives, and livened up the nights. Over time, the people of Britain came to know me as the regal fairy king of a fiefs nobody ever heard of. A fief nobody's heard of. Well, at least in the major cities, anyway. So I didn't know about you because I'm from the countryside. Sorry about that. I'll try to branch out more from now on. Still, this was a hard-fought battle in its own right. Can you imagine what it was like for me to have to act like nobility without any actual capital? I can. I can recall a few dozen times about... Wait a second.
Drifton!
I can recall a few dozen times I lied about my station so I could sing a love... So I could sing love songs to a beautiful woman that I met at the tavern. And indeed, there's nothing quite so tense as that.
Tristan?
As a fellow poet, Alberon, I have the greatest respect for what you've accomplished here. I don't suppose you'd be willing to give me a few in-depth lessons on how to roll fairy style, would you? If you really like to learn from me, I'd be glad to teach you what I know. Besides, with your music backing me up, I bet I'd be able to expand my clientele even more. Now I see, you're both scoundrels who can't be trusted around women.
Yup, you got that right.
Anyway, where should we sit, Alberon? My favorite table is the round one in the back on the raised floor. It's harder for other customers to see you there, and it gives you a full view of the whole pub. Now, how about we start with a toast of fruit water? Excuse me, cutie, are you the new server? Let the owner know we'll be using the table in the back, okay? Oh, well, we'd also like to order 4 apple waters.
Oh my god. Okay. She looks familiar. Yeah, she looks like a very interesting fairy server.
You got it. I'll have them ready in just a moment. Huh? Huh? Da Vinci? Whoa, no way! Kirby, it really is you! Oh man, you'll never... you'll never believe what happened to me. So after we got separated in the fog, I let my instincts lead me, and that brought me right back to the beach. Luckily, that beach was far enough away from that foggy woods I was able to follow the coastline east. Eventually, I caught sight of Salisbury here, and I figured I'd ought to be able to learn more in a populated city. And then when I got here...
An angel far too good for this world just appeared on my pub's doorstep.
She was very unsteady on her feet, but I could still see the fire deep in her deep blue eyes when she said, "What a lovely place! Would you let me work here for the rest of my life?"
Huh?
I never said that. What I said was I'm looking for my companions, but first can I have a glass of water, remember?
Well, if you ever change your mind, you just let me know. You're welcome to work here forever.
Yes, I heard you the first 100 times, Mike. Now, back behind the counter, I'll teach you how to make cocktails later.
Now the drunken talk, I was like,
The Vinci. My perfect angel. The Vinci.
Okay.
Anyway, that's my story. I'm glad you're okay, Kirby. You too, Tristan. Although, it looks like you still haven't found Mash yet. I see. You must be the other servant Kirby told us about. It's an honor to meet a renowned genius like yourself, Leonardo da Vinci. Who are you? I'm guessing the fact that you know my name means you're a servant from proper human history. I'm Oberon. Oberon the Fairy King. Though I guess here I'm more... it's more of an aspirational title. It's nice to meet you, Da Vinci. I'm Artorio Caster. I'm a Kirby in the Nameless Woods. To make a long story short, I'm going around with Kirby pretending to be your, owner. Seriously, that's hilarious! Thanks, Artoria, that must be a huge weight off Kirby's shoulders. But hey, since you're a British fairy, you're a British fairy too, right? You've probably got some idea of what it is we're doing here by now. But you're helping Kirby, so does that mean you're good with it? Well, more or less. Honestly, I don't really get even half of what Kirby and Oberon told me. But I do know that Kirby was telling the truth. I wouldn't feel right about abandoning someone in trouble when it's within my ability to help them. And honestly, it kinda seemed like fun.
Ah, yes. Time to help prevent the end of the world and also bring the end of the world as we know it in this Lost Belt. Ah, yes, that seems pretty fun.
Gotcha. Then it should be okay to speak frankly here. So, how'd you end up here, Kirby?
Well...
Wow, sounds like you guys had a hell of a time in that forest. I'm glad you made it out of there okay. Thanks for keeping her safe, Tristan. You too, Oberon, Artoria. So, we still don't know much about Britain. We have no idea where Mash is. But we do know that she's still alive. And Oberon is flat broke. Okay, now that we're all on the same page, we can figure out what to do next. You made the right call, Oberon. We shouldn't be wandering aimlessly around Britain right now. What we need to do is set up a base of operations here in Salisbury where we can gather information and tackle our problems one at a time. Our top priority right now is finding Mash, so we need to look out for info on a girl wearing iron armor. While we do that, we should also learn more about Britain and the lives of the fairies who live in it.
So, what do you have in mind for a base? Do you have a place of your own here?
I sure do. This pub doubles as an inn. Well, technically, they just copied a man-made inn without knowing what it was for.
Oh.
So, I taught Mike about inns and how to put all the extra rooms he got here to good use. And as a little reward for my services, I got to take three of the second floor rooms for myself.
You get three rooms?
I knew we'd eventually find each other, so that we need a Caldea frontline base when we did. So that's why I went ahead and made one.
Wow, I'm impressed, Da Vinci. And I know Lancelot would especially be blown away by what you've done here.
Huh, is this Lancelot person also a young girl?
In one sense, you're not wrong. Spit take.
This is great. I can already tell this Da Vinci friend of yours will be a great help.
Alright, since it seems like you guys have things well in hand now, I think I'll take my leave. I've actually got a lot of other things I still have to do.
You're going off on your own, Oberon.
Yep, I'm going to see what I can find out about this Mash girl. Not to mention, we also need more information about Britain as a whole. Now that you Chaldeans have come here, things are definitely going to change. And since we still don't have many allies on our side yet, I want to make sure we know where things stand in every region. But we will see you again, right?
Of course, especially now that I know where I can find you all. Don't worry, the next time you see me, I'll have good news. In the meantime, I suggest you all get acclimated to Britain sooner than later. Well, damn, he sure didn't waste any time. I'm glad he's on our side, but he definitely dances to the beat of his own drum, doesn't he?
Indeed, and that colorful outfit of his speaks to me. It tells me he is without a doubt the same kind of poet as me.
Ah, how this gladdens me.
So, what should we do now? I could show you around Salisbury if you like. Thanks, but I think we should take the rest of the day off. You all walked a long way to get here, after all. Please, go ahead and make yourselves comfy in the rooms I mentioned. Kirby, you take the room for yourself. Tristan and I will share another. Artoria, you can use the other room I set aside for Mash.
Hey, Say. Can't believe I got every limited 5-star Silver and Honkai Star Rail. I mean, it was a close call with this banner. But I definitely won't have enough for the next one, though, for Kafka and, wait, who else is coming up? Blade, I think? Was Blade the other 5-star? I definitely won't have enough saved up for them, though.
Especially with how stingy, like, miHoYo is with their currency, like, with their currency generation in general. Hey, Thousand Center, how you doing? But yeah, funnily enough, now that I pulled for Silverwolf, I don't have the mats to get her leveled up properly. So, whoo! A little bit awkward there. Anyways, let's see. And Artoria, you can use the other room I set aside for Mash. Huh, I knew I was right now settling for just two rooms. Oh, I also put up some Magecraft barriers in the room so we don't have to worry about being, overheard.
She said the thing.
I recognize that Da Vinci wink. Really? I can have a whole room all to myself, but for free. Hooray! I've always wanted my own room. I can't wait to get all comfy. Thank you, Da Vinci. Gosh, you proper human history fairies are all so generous. This is great.
Proper human history fairies.
You got lucky with Morgan and FGO and now Silverwolf and Star Rail. Hey, congrats! Hopefully the luck continues into the other banners. May you save your jade and not waste it on trying to get 5-star light cones.
Don't do it.
Don't be me. Technically, with the greedy pulls I tried for Jing's light cone, I actually might have completely screwed myself from not getting Silverwolf by doing those pulls like a couple days back. So yeah, I don't think I'll ever be touching light cone banners.
Like, man, I really wish they weren't so stingy with the pulls you can get in Star Rail. So at least you'd have, like, some tickets for the Lycone banners. Or hell, like, I'd be down if they just threw in, like, a third ticket currency specifically for the Lycone banner. And not just have the special tickets for either the limited character or the Lycone.
Like, bruh. Like, I wanted Jing's light cone so badly, man. Like, that looks so broken. And like, increased attack, like, crit damage or whatever it was, or even more follow-up damage. I'm like, bruh, that shit's stacked. Not pulling in light cone, you learned your lesson in Genshin. What do you mean? Pulling for weapons is totally a nice thing to use your currency on.
And now she's gone too. I know I didn't touch on this before, but she's pretty different from the Artoria we know, isn't she? Yes, she is. From what I've seen so far, we should consider her an entirely separate person from King Arthur, Artoria Pendragon, the King of Britain in proper human history. Yep, which is one more thing I'd like to discuss up in our room, if you two don't mind taking this there. It's better if we discuss proper human history stuff just among ourselves. You really can't be too careful here. Alright, let's begin by sharing what we learned, starting with this version of Britain. You probably got a sense of this yourselves on your way to Salisbury, but this Lostbelt is very different from all the others we've seen so far. It doesn't look at all like an alternate path human history could have taken, especially since humans aren't the dominant species here. So far as I can tell, this world almost consists entirely of fairies. In Russia, a huge cold snap made it impossible for the human species to survive as it were, so they are forced to adapt and evolve. In Scandinavia, the Twilight of the Gods, aka Ragnarok, happened during the Age of Gods, and both gods and people alike were in sharp decline afterward. China was ruled by a single Zenren, or true human, and became the sole nation-state in the entire world. India was converging in on itself through endless cycles of reincarnation, only for the whole world instead of individual people. And in Greece, humankind was completely dominated by gods who never died out. While all of them were dead ends, they were also human worlds. No matter how different they may have been from our timeline, they also had human societies that suited their environments in the year 2019. But that's not the case here. This is very much not a human world. For one thing, there is no world outside of Britain. It's not like the other Lost Belts where we just couldn't see the outside world thanks to the storm walls. There's just nothing in this world at all besides Britain, no other continents, and definitely no other nations. So as long as we're here, the whole planet consists of nothing but the Isle of Britain and the sea. And that means it's basically another world with no relation to human history? Yep, given what we know now, that's the only way to describe it. Over the last few days, I've been asking various fairies about what things are like between Britain and other countries, but the very idea of other countries was alien to them. So that tells me there must be some strange circumstance that happened to that caused this place to become Fairy Britain. Figuring out what that is will likely be our unraveling this Lost Belt. Hold on, if there aren't any other European countries here, does that mean every fairy in this land comes solely from the Isle of Britain?
Oh shit, I'm a 34% battery? Oh my god, I can't do this for much longer then.
That's a great question, Tristan. If there are no other lands in this world, it follows that no fairy legends from those places would be imported here. But luckily, there's still a little thing called human history convergence. What that means is, as long as a fairy once existed on Earth, their existence will remain even if their form and history are different. So even in this Fairy Britain, we have fairies from various European legends showing up in different forms. Basically, the ecosystems are similar even if the environments aren't. Since this is still the same planet Earth, there are inevitably going to be similar life forms, civilizations, and large-scale events.
Similar life forms, huh?
Yep, Fairy Britain may be nothing like the Britain we know. But despite that, the two Britons have a surprising number of things in common. Things like city names, fairy names, even the name of this world's queen. Remember that huge castle to the north you saw on the way here? It belongs to High Queen Morgan, ruler of Fairy Britain. And it probably won't surprise you to learn that its name is Camelot. That's right, here the same castle that symbolized British peace and proper human history. That was home to King Arthur and the Knights of the Round Table. Belongs to Morgan, the strongest, most despised witch in British history, the one indirectly responsible for King Arthur's death and Britain's downfall.
Morgan the Witch, huh?
Yep, as far as I've been able to find out, Morgan's ruled Fairy Britain for almost 2,000 years. There are 6 different fairy clans here: Wind, Earth, Fang, Mirror, Wing, and one other. They wage war with each other constantly for thousands of years. Until Morgan used evil magecraft to defeat them, subjugated half of the clans through force, and united all of Britain.
Peace by force, huh?
Afterwards, she gave the humans of this world a limited degree of freedom, and made them build a foundation for civilization. And developed this imitation society over the course of the last 2,000 years.
Morgan, so even in this Lost Belt, she's still trying to... But no, I suppose I shouldn't say that. I'm sure this Morgan is a different person from the one we know.
So what exactly is her reign like? Since she calls her castle Camelot, does that mean it's fair and just in a way King Arthur would be proud of?
No, it's pretty horrible. She has strict limits on the number of humans that can be born each year. She rules fairies with an iron fist. Every fairy that lives in an urban area is inscribed with Morgan's curse, command spells as part of their civic duty.
Huh?
Wait. Every fairy that lives in an urban area is inscribed with command spells. Huh. And every year, fairies inscribed with these command spells are forced to donate some of their vitality, magical energy, essentially. They call it the existence tax. Wait, everyone's inscribed with command spells? Huh. And any fairies who can't pay it, essentially who can't provide enough magical energy to satisfy Morgan, are killed right then and there.
Woo! What the heck?
Apparently, when she first took the throne, Morgan told the fairies, "I offer neither absolution nor salvation. I demand only that you obey without question or hesitation. Show me your fealty in word and action, and I shall keep Britain safe. Any fairies who can't handle this state of affairs and become unable to work are either taken to Camelot and dealt with there, or they escape the cities and run away to lands where no one knows about." So that's why those fairies were there. Such an oppressive regime is bound to spark opposition. But even so, Morgan has maintained her iron grip on Britain for 2,000 years. Yep, which goes to show just how powerful she must be. She takes half the soul of every fairy in Britain each year, and there's still no fairies able or willing to stand up to her. That said, there are some positive sides to Morgan's reign. Remember those black things we fought near the shore? The fairies call them Moors. They're one of the calamities that have been plaguing Fairy Britain since its inception. Occasionally, fairies that lose their purpose or their spark end up turning into these Moors creatures. Moors are essentially the fairies' natural predators. Just touching one is enough to infect a fairy, ultimately transforming them into a Moors too.
Basically, zombies.
It's kind of like a disease that only affects fairies. And the Moors aren't the only calamity Britain has to regularly contend with. There are lots of others that pop up on a regular basis. And Morgan's, the High Queen's army is constantly fending them off. Morgan may be a cold and ruthless ruler, but she's also the sword that keeps Britain safe. Fairies may fear and hate her, but they also depend on her. And that's the...
Hey, Sir Dirk, why are you double posting? Huh. You weren't double posting earlier.
Alrighty then. And that's the current state of affairs, or current state of Fairy Britain. Sounds like Morgan's definitely the Lostbelt's king then. Yep. And that seems like a very stable assumption, which means she'd also have to be the one who used Rungaminiad. That spell was so powerful to reach Olympus from here. No one else could have cast it. Though, of course, that unfortunately also means Barrel Gut is involved with Morgan somehow. So I'd say that makes our chances of peaceful negotiation with her basically nil.
I see. Then we have our own reason for defeating her.
Yep. Though we might have a hard time getting into Camelot, since apparently no one can enter it without her permission. That said, even Morgan's reign isn't perfect. In fact, there's new hope going around Britain right now. As luck would have it, we showed up here at the exact right time, just as things are about to change.
What's this new hope?
The Child of Prophecy. Specifically, a child whose existence was prophesied by the head of the now-extinct Mirror Clan, right before they disappeared. From what I heard, it went something like this. 16 years from now, a savior shall appear, guided by the Staff of Selection, the true king will take the throne. When the six bells ring out, the false queen will fall. Alongside Fae and humans, the savior will bring an end to this false history. So what do you think? Sounds vaguely familiar, right? It's got credibility out the wazoo too, since the Mirror Clan's prophecies have never once been wrong. The High Queen's been trying to prevent the inevitable by rounding up every fairy who turned 16 this year. But the fact that this Child of Prophecy hunt is still going on proves that she still hasn't been caught them, or she still hasn't caught them. Suffice to say, between the Moors and the Child of Prophecy alone, the cracks are showing in the High Queen's reign. So if we play our player cards right, we might just be able to negotiate with Morgan after all. That said, finding Mash definitely comes first. For the time being, you should rest up and recover your strength. Then tomorrow, we can start gathering information. Quietly and casually, of course, so as not to arouse suspicion.
Oh man, it feels like forever since I lay down on a soft bed.
The British Lostbelt. High Queen Morgan. Artoria. Avalon. Mash, wherever you are, please be safe.
With the Fragment chapters, kind of raising some red flags, but...
Okay, I think we can use some rest too. Servants might not need to sleep, but it's still tiring to be constantly watching out for threats, right? I mean, you never took your fingers off your bowstrings ever, or even once that entire time. Guess that's why you were a knight of the round table, huh? Huh. Just your noticing that suggests I must need rest as well. But not just yet. But please, don't refrain from resting on my account, Da Vinci. You may be a servant too, but you're also a being living in the here and now, just like Kirby. So go on, get some sleep. Don't worry. It's my duty to protect you and protect you as well as her. Gotcha. Guess I should have expected that kind of consideration from Tristan, the Child of Sadness, and the most handsome knight of the Round Table. Okay then, I'll take you up on that. Honestly, I was pretty beat. By all means, but first, I just have one request for you. I don't want to take too much of your time, but before you fall asleep, I was hoping you could tell me about the sixth singularity. Specifically, I would like to hear about the version of me who was summoned there, and what I was doing in the holy city of Camelot.
Oh, wait, what is Tristan trying to learn about the Tristan in... Wait, what? Huh. Alright, so I think with how much we gotta read, I'm not sure I can get through all of Chapter 3 right now. One more moment. Excuse me.
Good morning, everyone. My gosh, that bed was just so comfortable. Glad to hear it. Thanks all the trouble I went through to get the mattress just right, worth it. Fairy beds are just imitations of real beds, so the mattresses might as well have been boulders before I adjusted them.
I'm here as well. If you like, I'd be happy to play a song to help you all wake up.
Well, what are you waiting for? Let's get going.
Whoa there, I'm glad you're so fired up, but let's just take it easy, okay?
Yes, none of the High Queen's soldiers are here in Salisbury, but she definitely has sympathizers here. So we just need to play it cool and casual, okay?
You're going out, Da Vinci?
Oh my god, wait, no, that he doesn't know how to properly, like, pronounce or spell Da Vinci's name. Oh, okay, I thought like he was like partially drunk for some fucking reason. So he just interprets it as Da Vinci.
So you're not going to wait tables with your beautiful roller skating today?
Sorry, I'm about to do some sightseeing, but don't worry, I'll help out in the afternoon.
Oh, right, that was our deal, wasn't it? Hey, you there, I don't know which clan you're from, but you better not tire Da Vinci out of you here.
Oh my god.
Huh, what's up, Kirby? Something on your mind?
What's up with the sky?
Oh, that. Yeah, I was surprised about that at first, too. The weather here never changes. It's got one sky pattern for day, another for night, and that's it. It does supposedly rain here sometimes, but apparently it's always just cloudy here. No blue skies. Blue skies? Your written skies turn blue sometimes?
Yes. When there are no clouds in the sky, it becomes a beautiful shade of blue as far as the eye can see. Though, that's not to say these skies aren't beautiful in their own right.
So the same color as blue bells then? So, that's what your skies look like? Wow. Then your world must be very bright and beautiful. The kind of place where everyone always smiles and helps out one another, no matter how hard life gets.
Wow. Let her keep dreaming.
Anyway, shall we start gathering information then? Oh, I need to pretend to be Kirby's owner, right? Oh, then maybe I'll try acting like a big shot and going to one of those restaurants I heard so much about. Did you know they won't even let you into a Woodroses without an attendant? Hey, as long as there are a lot of fairies there, I'm good with whatever. Okay, so let's go to the place where we pretend to be just taking a walk. We also want to keep our ears peeled for any juicy rumors and talk to people ourselves at times.
Hold on real quick. Excuse me.
What? You guys interested in joining the High Queen's army?
Don't bother. Nothing good will come from joining them now.
This is the year Einstein prophesized about, remember? The Child of Prophecy will appear this year and bring salvation to all.
Who knows? Maybe the High Queen will finally cut us a break on our taxes if she actually takes a few licks. Oh wait. Takes a few licks for once.
Huh. You're not going to join? You're looking for a lost companion?
Huh. Well, afraid we can't help you then.
Iron armor? You won't find anything like that here. You have to go to Norwich for iron.
They ought to still be making those silly weapons up there. At least if Spriggan hasn't shut down the mine.
Spriggans?
What kind of weapons, you say? What else?
Swords, spears, bows, axes, you know, the usual.
I swear, I never thought I'd see the day fairies would use iron weapons of all things.
Ugh, excuse me.
What could the High Queen be thinking?
Excuse me.
Still, at least the Child of Prophecy should do something about all that. We just gotta be patient a little longer.
Hey, have you guys heard about the latest calamity pool in Norwich? They say Norwich's sky is pitch black right now, even during daytime. There's no way they're going to last much longer there, not with such calamity present. I mean, between all the iron, soot, noise, and humans there, they have no one to blame but themselves. But even so, I just can't help but worry. I mean, what are we going to do if Norwich refugees decide to come here to Salisbury? We have so much history here and we got too many Earthclan fairies as it is. The Lady Aurora is so kind, I can't imagine her turning them away.
Bird-like fairy.
You're looking for something? Are you searching just in Salisbury or all of Britain? If it's all in Britain, these fairies here aren't going to be of much help. It's so nice here in Salisbury that nobody ever wants to leave.
If you want to know what's going on in other cities, you'll just have to visit them yourself. Oh, but you don't have wings, do you? Well, there was that out then. If the Moors get you, it's all over. Anyway, I wonder what tonight's festival was going to be about. I always loved the play about the child of prophecy and the evil witch. I love the part where the High Queen and her Dog Knight finally gets what's coming to them.
Oh. Dog Knight, huh? Worn out. Fed up. Dejected. Okay, so not much luck today, huh? I mean, I wasn't really expecting to find a solid lead in just one day. But all anyone wanted to talk about was the Child of Prophecy. They barely even listened to what we had to say. Indeed, that last fairy even tried to get us to buy some questionable Child Prophecy merchandise. I haven't seen a whole city so feverishly excited about something other than Christmas. A Child of Prophecy craze, huh? Sounds like there's a lot of money to be made there. Oh my god, Tristan. Okay, hold on. I think like my shoulders are. Stretch my shoulders a bit here. I wonder who this Child of Prophecy could be anyway. Yeah, the only other thing these fairies wanted to talk about besides the Child of Prophecy were the rumors going around about Norwich, the eastern port town. I gotta say, it's made me really curious about this Child of Prophecy too. I wonder what kind of fairy they are. If they really are planning to find Morgan like the prophecy says, maybe we could even convince them to help us. What do you think? Should we try looking for this Child of Prophecy as well, Mash? Or as well as Mash? Any fairy who can get other fairies... Oh wait. Any fairy who can get the other fairies so excited must be incredibly strong and brave.
That blush of embarrassment and that smug-ass cocky smile, like, yep, that's me they're talking about. Yep.
Good day, everyone. I'm back once again. Oh, not as many customers today, I see. Over here, Oberon. Hey there, having a little lunch after your morning walk around the city, huh? Anyway, it looks like you're all having fun. I hope you don't mind if I join you. I'm a passable fighter at best, but I'm a master of killing with compliments. Much more peaceful that way. Here, I'll show you. Before long, I'll be heaping so much praise on Artoria, she'll be begging me for mercy. Artoria? Why? Huh, you mean you haven't told them yet, Artoria? The Child of Prophecy everyone's on about. That's her.
Alright, we're not just gonna, like, we're not just gonna dance around this whole thing. You're just gonna upfront say, hey, you haven't told them you're the Child of Prophecy? Alright then.
I just assume you knew since she's got King Arthur's name and all. I mean, yeah, the thought did cross my mind once I heard you were named Artoria. But still, you, Artoria? Really? I mean, let's be real. You have less magical energy than most fairies, right? You might have better magical circuits than a human. Well, since you're a fairy, I guess, wait, hold on. I guess they'd be Age of Gods patterns. Anyway, they're still far below, below average for a fairy. Hell, even Mike there must be stronger than you. So how can you be the Child of Prophecy meant to defeat the High Queen?
Mood.
But I know, you're right. It doesn't make sense, right? Or does it? I'm sorry.
Mood, Av.
I'm so sorry. I know it's not right that someone like me is carrying around the Staff of Selection. Still, it's not like we know for certain that I'm the Child of Prophecy. There's a chance I might not be. Besides, I don't really have the guts to fight the High Queen or the drive or the determination. I don't belong to any of the clans either, and I have so little magic energy that I have to fudge it with magecraft. I can't even get close to the bells I'm supposed to ring. I mean, I do plan to do the best I can in spite of all that. But let's just say it's a very uphill battle. I still don't know why I was chosen.
Because Lazengla needs to make money.
You don't think you can do this, Artoria? I don't know. All I can say is that if I really am the Child of Prophecy, then there must be some way for me to fight.
Yeah, you buff up any other art servants that will just sweep house.
It's why I was born, and how I was raised. Oh, and who am I kidding? I'm completely hopeless. The last time I came to Salisbury was to meet with the head of the Wind Clan. But I ended up deciding to try Manchester next because nobody here would even give me the time of day. I see, so that's why you didn't say anything sooner. Fairies can sense how much magic energy you've got at a glance, so I'm sure they only laugh when you told them you're the Child of Prophecy. I bet they also yelled at you and told you not to lie. They did, so I thought I'd stop by convincing the head of the clan who I was. But they just turned me away at the gate. Oh, the head of the Wind Clan, huh? That'd be Aurora. Personally, I think you're pretty great as you are now. But I can see why you feel a need to boost your prestige. Well, if that's the only problem, I can take care of it right now. Oh, what do you mean by that, Alberon? I mean, I can get you a meeting with Aurora if you want.
Just like that! Alright, we in there.
There, see how easily we got in? Take a look. This is the heart of Salisbury, the home of its great bell. As Cathedral, the oldest and largest building in all of Fairy Britain. Now then, Aurora's room is on the top floor, so let's say we start heading up. I've already sent word of our arrival, so we shouldn't have any trouble with the guard. Whoop, hang on. Oh. Good day, King of the Autumn Woods. Your visit is sudden and unexpected, but we welcome you here all the same. Aww. However, it seems I must remind you that this cathedral is the holy ground where kings and queens are made. The esteemed site of High Queen Morgan's coronation 2,000 years ago. As such, regardless of how much affection Lady Aurora must have for you.
Oh.
I cannot allow such lowly creatures as humans to enter, attendants or not. Guards, to me, capture these unidentified fairies and that disgusting human. The human submits very well. However, should she attempt to resist or flee, dispose of her. That goes for Alberon too, of course. You needn't show him any leniency. We received complaints about him from pubs across the city demanding that he pay his tabs.
Bro! Oh my god! Alberon!
My, this isn't how I expected things to go.
Alberon!
If those are your orders, Lady Coral, then we'll gladly comply, but are you sure about this? Lady Aurora told us that let her through right away. She seemed thrilled about his visit. Don't you talk back to me. You may have been chosen to be guards, but you're still mere humans. Know your place. Unless, of course, you'd rather I turned you into rabbits so you don't have to be human anymore.
No, my lady, I'm very sorry about this,
No, my lady, I'm very sorry about this, Lord Alberon. It really is nothing personal, we're just doing our jobs. It seems we have no choice but to do battle, even though their hearts clearly aren't in it. Come, Kirby, let us show them how strong we truly are.
Well.
Oh, right, I only have Musashi here. Cost limit? Oh, right. Actually, how many bond points am I away? Okay, I'm 64k from Bond 8 with Tamamo Lancer. 500k for Tamamo Cat. And I still need a million for Caster Tamamo so I can actually get enough servant coins to get her to 120. Oh my goodness. It's so far away, man. Holy shit. And now that we're actually in a battle, I can actually continue eating my cookie. I'm still hungry. You see that, Coral? You see what Kirby and I are capable of? This is what happens when you look down on people for being human or having no money! Probably not a good time to point that out. Auburn was just standing behind them cheering. Very well. It would seem that human is indeed not your typical expendable worker. And Lady Aurora does love rare and unusual things. It's part of what makes her so strong. Alright, just this once, I'll grant you an audience with her, but don't let this go to your head. Rare and unusual things are only interesting in the first time you see them. Once the novelty wears off, they become worthless. If I were you, I would try to make the most of this good fortune, as you won't have many other chances, other such chances in the future. Oh, the reveal. Ah, she looks beautiful. Huh. Holy shit, her wings are so like, are so vivid. Oh my god. Huh. Hello, Auberon. What delightful story do you have for me today? You know so very many things, so I'm sure it must be something special. Whatever it is, I can't wait to hear it. I could use some cheer after all the unfortunate news recently. Oh my god, she's... I didn't think it was possible to go blind from sheer splendor until today. Well, yes, I have two things for you today. One is something you absolutely must know. The other is a request for a small favor. But don't worry, I won't take up much of your time at all. That said, can I first make a somewhat selfish request? You see, I'd like to keep what I'm about to tell you just between us. You don't mind keeping secrets, right? Oh my, you are a naughty one, aren't you? I don't usually care for scary stories. But, teehee, a little thrill does sound like fun. Would you give us some privacy, Coral? Lady Aurora? It's alright, I know we can trust them since it's only right I answer in kind. As you wish, but please, don't hesitate to call for me if you should change your mind.
You'll have to forgive Coral. She's a very proud girl, and she can be quite inflexible. She probably gave you a very harsh welcome again, didn't she? I'm just glad to see you're not hurt. It's a pleasure to make your acquaintance, friends of Oberon. I'm Aurora, the head of the Wind Clan and Lord of Salisbury. Now, what did you come to tell me today? Oh, I guess it's no surprise that the whole mood just changed in here. Because she didn't become head of the clan through her beauty alone. Well, you see, there's a stranded friend of ours we've not been able to find. Oh my, oh my, oh my, oh my. How many years has it been since a human spoke so frankly to me? Ooh, how delightfully different. Tell me, what's your name? Are you a free citizen? What kind of pedigree do you... Oh. I'm so sorry, you already serve this fine young fairy, don't you? Oh goodness, how rude of me. Really, Aurora, you must do something about your tendency to take every stray human you find. Otherwise, you'll eventually have every human in Britain living in Salisbury. And I'm sure you don't need any more resistance from your fellow clan members seeing how you're the only one who favors coexistence. Yes, I know. You're right, of course. But when I saw those big doe-eye-livers begging me for help, well, I just couldn't resist. Oh, good grief. Well, this is exactly why I brought her to see you to begin with. Remember what I told you before about Chaldea and the other world called proper human history? Well, this girl here is the master of Chaldea, and the two people behind her are servants, not fairies. Oberon? Don't worry, it's okay. Aurora here may be from Fairy Britain, but she thinks a lot like the fairies of proper human history. And while she'd never come out and say it, she's not happy with the state of things in Britain either, right? It's been 2,000 years now since Britain fell into Morgan's hands. And you've been here watching it unfold every step of the way. You think it's time for Morgan's reign to end, regardless of what form that end takes. I remember how your eyes sparkled with hope when I told you about the outside world. Kirby here has come to Britain solely to defeat Morgan. She's not even thinking about what happens afterwards. Suffice to say, she has no intention of ruling in Morgan's place when she's gone. Once the Chaldeans leave, whether Britain lives or dies will be for you and your fellow fairies to decide. Chaldea's definitely not going to care if you try and save what's left of it. They'll gladly stay out of your way. Morgan is their only concern, nothing more. So it would seem... While that girl in the back doesn't seem very happy that you're telling me this, this girl here isn't denying anything you say. So you're travelers from another world. A Britain that went down the right path. It's still hard to believe, but maybe this too is Einzel's guidance at work. Either way, one thing is clear. Since we both have our own troubles, it's only right that we help one another out. Kirby, was it? You have my permission to act in Salisbury however you see fit, even if your actions should be in opposition to the land of the Fae. If you're looking for a lost companion, then I'll lend you the eyes of my fellow Wind Fairies in the other cities.
22% battery.
I can't contact my compatriots in Norwich at the moment. But I will have my Wind Fairies in Oxford, Gloucester, New Darlington, and Camelot help you in your search. You need only tell Cora what your companion looks like. I just hope my clan can be of assistance. That's great, but are you sure it's okay? You mean for me to help Chaldea? Hehe. Since you're both, I see you're both a kind and honest girl, Kirby. True, as a citizen of Fairy Britain, perhaps it's wrong of me to help you. But I'm more concerned with us Fae folks' way of life than I am with retaining this land itself. The High Queen is a great woman, certainly. But the path we are on now would not lead us anywhere good. All that said, I'd still like to keep this relationship of ours on the down low for the time being. After all, you are the head of a clan. If Morgan finds out you've sided with Chaldea in proper human history, she may have all the Wind Clan fairies killed. So this collaboration should be kept quiet, so we can deny knowing anything about each other in case things come to that. All the Wind Clan fairies dead. So not even you could defeat High Queen Morgan if you face her directly? No, I couldn't. She could wipe us all out with one flick of her finger. I see. Gosh, she really is something, isn't she?
Oh yeah, she's a very special fairy. The only one who could hope to defeat her is a child of prophecy from Einz's last prediction. It's too bad this child has yet to reveal themselves. I can only hope they come save us as soon as possible.
Devious smile. He's gonna do it. He's really gonna do it.
How right you are, Aurora. I may very well be about to make your day. There's someone I'd like you to meet.
Well, what are you doing, Oberon? Please stop, stop.
That's right. Artoria here is none other than the Star of Hope who hails from Tintagel. Born alongside the Staff of Selection that will bring Morgan to justice. She's the one, the only, Child of Prophecy.
Go on now, don't be shy. Oberon!
Fuck.
You do have some delightful friends, Oberon. I'd love to be tackled to the ground like that myself sometime.
Let's not go there.
Why, thank you. I can't say I expected such a direct method of silencing me either.
Still, Artoria would never say anything if I hadn't put her on the spot like that.
She's kind of a late bloomer, you see, and she's still not confident about being the Child of Prophecy. So we were hoping you might be able to offer her your seal of approval. Say, for example, maybe she can ring one of the bells mentioned in the prophecy?
Oh?
Wow, even I wouldn't have come up with that. Impressive.
No, that I'm afraid I cannot allow. While there is indeed a bell said to be the voice of the Wind Clan right above this room, I can only let her ring it once she has proven herself to me. Words alone would not suffice. She would need to demonstrate her ability so that there can be no question. You said your name was Artoria, yes? And it seems you do indeed have the Staff of Selection. I still don't understand what the Staff of Selection truly signifies. The only one who does is Einzel, the head of the Mirror Clan, and no one has seen any member of the Mirror Clan for years. All I can do is see for myself whether you have the makings of a king. And how exactly do you propose to do that? Oh my, what a lovely voice. And here I thought you may be a mute. Very well then, out of respect for those dulcet tones, I'll tell you my conditions. Artoria, Kirby. I would like you two to show me that there is still hope for our world. So here is my test to see if Britain can still be changed. As you know, we fairies are plagued by a dark fate. Every 100 years, a calamity befalls us, a curse that not even Morgan herself has been able to dispel. For the last few months, there has been a powerful Morse current winding its way through Norwich, a calamity pool. If you two can rid Norwich of this calamity, then I'll gladly give you access to Salisbury's bell.
Deal.
Woo, okay, oh boy, I don't think I can let my battery go all the way to finish this with how long each section is. Bro, I know I've seen the stack of papers outlining the script for Lostbelt 6 in all of its entirety for parts 1 to 3, but oh dear god. Oh dear god, my battery is not gonna last. I pray that my battery will be able to survive the entirety of Lostbelt 6, acts 1 to 3. Because right now, I think I want to give my poor phone a break. I don't want to keep draining my battery all the way to like single digit percentages for this. So I think we covered a good amount of FGO today. So I'm just gonna, what was it?
Wait, I was gonna leave FGO here for tonight, and I think I'll actually, do I want to do more Star Rail stuff after? Actually, no, now that I'm kind of like, feeling my, throat out for a moment, it is getting a little bit sore from all the reading I've been doing again. So I think I'll leave the stream here for tonight. I started pretty dang early, actually, all things considering. So yeah, I'm just gonna leave FGO here, rest my voice and everything, and get ready for another night of Lostbelt reading tomorrow. And we will keep on this, we will keep on, reading Lostbelt 6 in its entirety until it's done. So, unless, I'm way too tired to speak or commentate from all the reading I've been doing, it'll be FGO until it's done. And eventually we'll get back to Trails of Cold Steel 4, speaking of which I need to actually export the VODs tomorrow. And, and also get to exporting the FGO VODs as well, now that we've started the Lostbelt 6 reading and everything. So yeah, that'll be it for tonight.